see the continuation of 9th chapter. Already I have uploaded 2 parts in the 9th chapter. This is the last part. Before we see until STEMI and non-STEMI. Now we are going to see AMI, acute myocardial infarction. If it is unspecified, how we have to code? For acute myocardial infarction, for unspecified, the code is I21.9. In this, if type 1 STEMI or transmural MI is there, but if the documentation is without mentioning the site, then we have to assign I21.3 STEMI unspecified. Don't confuse, I21.9 is for AMI unspecified, acute myocardial infarction unspecified, but I21.3 is for STEMI unspecified. And the next topic is AMI documented as non-transmural or subendocardial, but the site is provided. Means the AMI still should be coded as subendocardial AMI. The next one is subsequent AMI. Subsequent AMI is it is followed by the main AMI, acute myocardial infarction. I22 category codes are used for STEMI and non-STEMI for type 1 or unspecified AMI. These codes only used for STEMI or non-STEMI, but type 1 or unspecified AMI means we have to use I22 codes, I22 category codes. And I22 category codes can be used along with I21 category codes, but the sequencing is based on the encounter of the patient's visit or admission of the patient. For subsequent type 2 AMI means we have to assign I21.A1 code. For subsequent type 4 or 5 AMI means then we have to assign I21.A9 code. If the subsequent AMI is of one type occurs within 4 weeks of AMI of another type, already the another type of AMI is there, but the subsequent AMI is occurs within 4 weeks of another type of AMI, then we have to assign appropriate I21 category codes to identify the type of AMI. We should not assign I22 category codes. For subsequent AMI codes, we should not assign subsequent AMI codes. We have to assign I21 category codes to identify the type of AMI. And I22 should be used as I22 category codes should only be used if both initial and subsequent AMI are type 1 and or unspecified AMI. If it is a type 1 or unspecified AMI, then only we have to, if both initial and subsequent AMI are type 1 or unspecified AMI, then only we have to use I22 category codes. And the next topic is other type of MI, other type of myocardial infarction, how we have to code. I21.0 to I21.4 and I21.9 is for type 1 myocardial infarction. I21.A1 is for myocardial infarction of type 2 with the code of underlying disease. We have to give add-on code for underlying disease code also. We have to give along with I21.A1 code. And we should not assign I24.8 code for other forms of acute ischemic heart disease. And I21.A1 is for type 2 AMI with STEMI and non-STEMI. And I21.A9 is for type 3, then type 4A, 4B, 4C and type 5 AMIs. We have to refer code also, and code first should be followed related to any complications or and for coding any post procedural myocardial infarction during or followed by the cardiac surgery. So this is the guidelines for chapter 9 in ICD-10-CM. If you are having any doubts, please do comment in the comment section or personal email me. I will reply you as soon as possible. I hope you all like the video. If you like the video, please do like, comment and share. And if you are still not subscribed our channel, kindly subscribe our channel and press the bell icon near to the subscribe button then only you will get all the notification of our channel. Thank you from Bhuma Devi Chandrasekharan.